Thank you so much for having us here this evening. We will tell you a little bit about each piece as we go along. So as the choir is getting into place, I'm going to tell you a little bit about O Magnum Mysterium, which is the piece that we just sang. Set to music by a variety of composers from the early centuries until today, O Magnum Mysterium is a text from the Holy Matins of Christmas describing the wonderment of the animals as they gazed on Christ in the stable. The words translate to, O great mystery and wonderful sacrament, that animals should see the newborn Lord lying in the manger. Amen. Lisa's going to tell you a little bit about our next piece.
Do you hear what I hear? Written in 1962, Do You Hear What I Hear was actually a plea for peace during the Cuban Missile Crisis. Written by a married couple, Gloria Shane and Noel Rainey, it was originally recorded by the Harry Simeon Chorale, but has since appeared on several dozen holiday albums by a variety of artists.
Give them a minute to put their candles away. Logistics are always a little bit of an issue.
Fum, fum, fum talks of the birth of Jesus in the lowly stable, as well as the celebration of that birth. The word fum means smoke in Catalan. But there's also a theory that in this song, the word may refer to the banging of a drum or strumming of a guitar during a holiday celebration.
I wonder as I wonder how
the birth of Jesus, followed by full expressions of joy marking the occasion. We're singing it in both English and Latin.
Thank you.
movement from Benjamin Britten's A Ceremony of Carols, this little babe includes a very unusual text from the poem New Heaven, New War by 16th century English Jesuit poet Robert Southwell, 1561 to 1595. The poem catalogs the panorama of the Nativity, from the divine baby's human trembling and tears to the stable's crumbling walls and the hay-filled manger and surrounding shepherds, but in a far different manner than Silent Night or other songs about the Nativity.
Did you know that your baby born will one day walk on water?
Michael Isaacson, who has been proclaimed one of the 10 most accomplished Jewish sacred music composers in America, like the legend, lets the singer share the joy of the Hanukkah and the story of the Maccabean revolt against their Syrian oppressors. It encourages us to tell the age-old story of how they were able to keep the lights burning in the temple, even though their supply of oil should have only lasted for one day, inspiring this yearly 8-day festival.
Thank you.
his instrumental only, done by Arthur Fiedler and the Boston Pops in 1949. But you can find it with lyrics on a variety of Christmas albums by artists ranging from the Carpenters to the Spice Girls and Gwen Stefani.
Ding, 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 ding
Thanksgiving in Turkey. This fun song allows our voices to imitate the dings and dongs we associate with ringing in the holiday and includes texts that allude to the chiming of bells to mark and celebrate Christmas morning and the birth of the baby Jesus.
Christmas presents, countryside covered with snow. Oh,
which, by the way, was actually written for Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving Day Parade. Did anybody see us? We were
way to kick off our 10th anniversary season. So we're going to finish with Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas, which Lisa's going to tell you a little bit about. Please feel free to sing along with us.
Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas. Written in 1943, Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas was first introduced in the movie Meet Me in St. Louis, starring Judy Garland. Frank Sinatra later recorded a version with slightly modified lyrics. This popular Christmas tune appears as number 76 in the American Film Institute's 100 Years, 100 Songs rankings of the top tunes in American cinema.
And the intro features our wonderful pianist.